how to back up 1Password, and why you should. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You already know by now that I am a huge proponent of backing up. But there's one program that I really hope you're using that you might not think to back up, and that's your password vault. Yes, you should explicitly back up your password vault. I'll describe how we do that in 1Password and then review why it's so important. To back up 1Password, we're going to use the desktop application, the desktop 1Password application. So I'm just clicking on the start menu here, typing the number 1 because 1Password is the first result. Since I haven't done this for a while, of course, I have to unlock my vault, and there it is. It's a vault full of random stuff. It's my example 1Password vault. To back up the vault, we use export. That's on this vertical ellipses, export, and then here you'll say it gives me the name of my vault. If you have more than one vault open, you'll be able to choose which one to export. I recommend you repeat this process for each of the vaults that you happen to be using. Fortunately, most of you are probably only going to be using one vault. So I'll click on that vault. This is the export dialog. Now, the very first thing you have to do, of course, is type your master password. This prevents someone from just walking up to your machine and exporting your vault for themselves. We'll enter the password. There are two formats we get to choose from. 1PUX, which is 1Password's internal format, and CSV, which is a generic format. We're going to export in both formats. I'll explain why in a moment. So I've selected the 1PUX format. I've entered my master password. It's now asking for a folder in which to place the export. I'm going to place mine in this example folder that I've created. And that's it. The export of the 1PUX is done. I'm going to repeat the process, export. Same thing, have to enter the password. This time I'm selecting CSV and export data. Once again, we need to select the folder into which that export is to be placed, and it's done. Okay, why two formats? Why these two formats? Well, you can see for one thing that if we take a look at them in the example folder, they're slightly different in size. 1PUX is probably twice as big here as the CSV. 1PUX is the 1Password internal format. It contains everything that's in your vault. It is perfect for importing into another or a new instance of 1Password. But that's about all it's good for. The CSV, on the other hand, is a generic format. It stands for comma separated values. This is a format that you could open in a spreadsheet program if you wanted to examine the contents of this vault. However, because not all of the fields that 1Password can save are standard, it's unable to actually include those in this generic format. It includes all the important stuff, your accounts, your account usernames, your passwords, the URLs, and so forth. But some of the other things that 1Password may be asked to store may not be the kinds of things that can be included in the CSV. This is why I suggest you do it twice. Once, with 1PUX so that you have everything to be imported into another instance of 1Password, and CSV so you have the important stuff in case importing into another instance of 1Password is not in the cards. It may in fact be even simpler to just open up a spreadsheet to examine the contents of the CSV file depending on the situation you find yourself in. Okay, now at this point, you should probably be yelling at me. And I say that because there's something incredibly insecure about what we've just done. These two files that are in the file folder on your screen, they are not encrypted. In fact, 1Password told us as we were doing this, make sure to save unencrypted files in a safe location. Anyone who has access to the file will be able to see the information in it. So, save in a safe location is the key concept. It doesn't have to be convenient, in fact, it probably shouldn't be, but it must be secure. A couple of ideas. Copy these files to a USB stick and place that in a safe. Or encrypt the files using perhaps a different tool with a strong password that you'll remember, of course, and then place the encrypted files somewhere where you'll be able to find them later if needed. Basically, any other technique that prevents anyone but yourself from being able to access the contents of these files is perfect, as long as it's a technique then that allows you to find and access the files when you need them. Now, there is one more thing. After we've copied these files to a safe place, we're really tempted to just go ahead and delete them, which I've done. Except I haven't. This is Windows File Explorer, and if we take a look at the recycle bin, we'll see that the files are still there. They could be recovered from the recycle bin. That implies that at a minimum, you either need to empty the recycle bin, which I'm doing right now, or you need to use Shift-Delete when you delete the files originally. Now, that is 99% of what you need to do. There's an additional 1%. If you are particularly concerned about someone being able to run forensic data recovery or undelete utilities in order to recover these files, then you might also consider running a free space wiping program after you have deleted and emptied the recycle bin. Okay, how often? Well, it kind of varies. It depends really on how often you change the contents of your vault. New accounts and password changes happen all the time. And Vault can contain a lot of other things that may or may not change as you use them. Personally, I use 1Password heavily. I back it up at minimum at least once a quarter. Ideally, I back it up every month. Just remember that if you ever need your backup, you'll lose all of the changes that have been made since that most recent backup. Why do you have a separate backup? If you've been backing up your machine, as I recommend, with a full system image backup, then a full restore will restore your vault as it was at the time you took the backup. That's great for a bunch of scenarios, but not all of them. For example, it is effectively impossible to locate your vault within an image and then restore it separately, should you ever need to. The only way to get a copy of your 1Password vault from within a full backup would be to restore the complete image, boot from it, run 1Password, and then export the vault as we've described above. That's a tricky path at best. By backing up separately, you've made one of your most important resources significantly easier to recover should the need ever come up. Why back it up at all? Well, to put it bluntly, stuff happens. And even worse, we can't predict what's going to happen and when it's going to happen. Since we put so much critical information into our password vaults, it would be a serious pain, though not a complete disaster, should we lose access to it for any reason. That could happen through forgetting our password, a problem with the vault itself, or some other random event. By backing this up periodically and separately, we create a safety net that means we can recover gracefully no matter what happens. So, bottom line, yes, use a password vault if you're not already. I still claim it is the most secure solution compared to all of the other alternatives. Then, back it up periodically. You may be very, very glad at some point that you did. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177851. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.